Amen, amen. God bless you. Can you please stand? Amen. How many are happy to be in the house of the Lord? Amen, amen. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. Dear Lord, at this time, Fathers, as we're here, Lord, to open up this service, Father, we just ask, Lord, that you come down, Father, and you be with each and every one of us today, Father. We want to give you thanks, Lord, for giving us another day of life, Father, to come and serve you, Lord, and hear your word today, Father. We love you, Lord. God bless all of my brothers and sisters here, everybody that's online with us today, Father. God bless them, Lord. We love you, Father, and all this we ask in your precious and holy name, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen, amen. Welcome to my Father's house. Oh, welcome to my Father's house. You're welcome. Oh, welcome to my Father's house. Come in. Enter his gates with thanksgiving in your heart. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Welcome. Oh, and welcome to my Father's house. You're welcome. Oh, welcome to my Father's house. Come in. Oh, enter his courts with thanksgiving in your heart. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Although these walls were made by human hands, there's nothing mystical about what's made by man. He's here, I feel him in the air. In my Father's house, his spirit's everywhere. Oh, welcome to my Father's house, you're welcome. Oh, welcome to my Father's house, come in. Oh, and enter his court with thanksgiving in your heart. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Y no hay Dios tan grande como tú. No lo hay, no lo hay. Y no hay Dios tan grande como tú. Jesús, yo te amo. Jesús, yo te amo. Jesús, yo te amo a ti. Porque tú me has salvado. Porque tú me has salvado. Jesús, yo te amo a ti. Otra vez. Oh, Jesús, yo te amo. Jesús, yo te amo. Jesús, yo te amo a ti. Porque tú me has salvado. Porque tú me has salvado. Jesús, yo te amo a ti. How good it is to give thanks unto the Lord. How good it is to give thanks unto our God. For he heals the brokenhearted, yes, binding up their wounds. And it is good to bless his holy name. How good it is to give thanks unto the Lord. How good it is to give thanks unto my God. For he heals the brokenhearted, yes, binding up their wounds. And it is good to bless his holy name. And we give thanks, and we give thanks unto our Savior. And with our hearts of gratitude, we give him praise. His mercy shall endure forever. brokenhearted, binding up their wounds, and it is good to bless His holy name. Oh, and it is good to bless His holy name. Amen, amen. Do you love Him? Amen. Is He good to you? Amen. We love Him with all of our hearts. Let us just sing to Him and worship. Worship Him with all of our hearts as we sing that song. Él volverá.
En el mundo perdido me hallaba cuando Él me encontró. Y no existía esperanza en mi vida, no era feliz. Pero gracias al Dios que nos ama, Él me libertó. Jesús haya puesto en mi ser,
en el mundo otra vez más.
Oh, el mundo perdido me hallaba cuando Él me encontró.
No existía
y no existía esperanza en mi vida, no era feliz. Oh, pero gracias al Dios que nos ama, Él me libertó. Esperanza en mi vida, Jesús haya puesto en mi ser. Oh, qué gozo, y oh, qué gozo yo siento en mi alma, Jesús mora en mí. Es un gozo, oh, y es un gozo tan grande que quiero servirle hasta el fin. Su palabra.
Bowed, as we ask our brother Ronnie Gonzalez to come forth. If there's any unspoken prayer request out there, just let it be known by the uplifting of your hand. If you have a need, I believe with all my heart that He's here with us.
We have a couple of written petitions here.
Unas peticiones escritas.
One from Brother Jacob.
Una de nuestro hermano Jacob.
Please help me pray for my daughter.
Ayúdeme a orar por mi hija.
Amanda Mizell.
Amanda.
And also for Brother Daniel Martinez. He is having some issues with his stomach.
Nuestro hermano Daniel Martinez está batallando con un problema en su estómago.
If you have a need, just make it known by the uplifting of your hands this evening.
Hágalo saber con su mano alzada si tiene una necesidad.
Amen. How many believe that we came to the right place?
¿Cuántos creen que llegamos al lugar propio?
Not these four walls.
No, este es cuatro paredes.
But in His presence, amen.
Pero en su presencia.
Amen. Let us pray.
Oremos.
Precious and heavenly Father.
Agraciado Padre Celestial.
Lord Jesus. We count this such a great privilege, Lord.
Damos este, Señor, un gran privilegio.
Lord, to first of all be in your presence, Lord.
Estar en tu presencia, Señor.
Lord, that's where we always want to be.
Ahí donde queremos estar siempre.
That's where we want to dwell, Father.
Ahí queremos morar, Padre.
It is in your presence, Father.
En tu presencia, Señor.
In the heavenly places, Lord.
En lugares celestiales.
Lord, and as we're here as a body of believers,
y como un cuerpo de creyentes aquí,
Lord, each one of us bring our portion, Father.
Cada quien trayendo su porción.
Lord, and as we believe that we are sitting in heavenly places,
y creyendo que estamos sentados en lugares celestiales,
Lord, whatever issue, Father, that Brother Daniel may be having in his stomach, Lord.
Cualquier que sea el problema que tiene nuestro hermano Daniel en su estómago, Padre.
Lord, you are the high priest that can be touched by the feeling of our infirmities.
Eres el sumo sacerdote que puede ser tocado por nuestras enfermedades.
Lord, and at this moment,
en este momento,
Lord Jesus, we send the agent of the Holy Ghost to where he may be at this moment.
Mandamos a la gente del Espíritu Santo donde él esté.
Lord, maybe he's there listening to this right now.
O sea, él está oyendo este mensaje.
Lord, maybe he feels a burning sensation in his stomach, Lord.
Se siente una sensación que le quema en el estómago.
Lord God, may that be, Father, your Holy Spirit correcting, Father.
Sea tu Espíritu Santo ahí, Señor.
May it be restoring, Father, anything that may be wrong in his stomach, Lord.
Restaurando todo lo que esté mal ahí, Señor.
Lord, for Brother Jacob's daughter, Lord.
Por la hija de nuestro hermano Jacob, Señor.
Amanda.
Amanda.
Lord, there's not a reason why they're asking for prayer, Lord.
No hay una razón por qué estar pidiendo por oración, Señor.
Lord, just for help.
Más por ayuda.
Lord, whatever may be here issue at this moment, Lord.
Lo que sea esa necesidad, Padre.
Lord, again we say, Father,
lo volvemos a decir, Señor.
By the power of the Holy Ghost,
por el poder del Espíritu Santo,
we lose that agent to Sister Amanda, your daughter.
Soltamos ese agente del Espíritu Santo a tu hija Amanda.
Whatever may be the issue in her, Lord,
lo que sea el asunto,
we believe, Father, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Creemos que eres el mismo de ayer, hoy, y por siempre.
Lord, and you can touch her where she may be at.
Tócala donde quiera que esté.
You can touch Brother Daniel wherever he may be at.
Nuestro hermano Daniel, donde él esté.
Lord, and you can touch all my brothers that are there online also, Lord.
Todos mis hermanos que están conectados.
Lord, all around the United States.
Todo alrededor de los Estados Unidos.
Lord, maybe in Mexico.
Quizás en México.
Africa.
África.
Colombia.
Colombia.
Wherever anybody may be listening to this.
Donde quiera que ellos estén oyendo.
Our God knows no distance.
Nuestro Dios no conoce distancia.
Lord, and if my brothers and sisters,
y para mis hermanos,
if you lift up your hand and raise your hand believing,
si usted levantó su mano creyendo,
you may have what you ask for.
Que usted tenga lo que haya pedido.
Not by my words.
No por mis palabras.
But by the finished work on Calvary.
Pero por la obra terminada en el Calvario.
Lord, for all the uplifted hands here in the building.
Por todas las demás manos alzadas.
Lord, you know the need behind each and every hand, Father.
Tú conoces cada necesidad detrás de cada mano.
Lord, touch them, Lord.
Tócalos.
If they're asking for strength,
si piden por fuerzas,
give them the strength, Father.
Dáselas.
Lord, you are our high tower that we can run to, Lord.
Tú eres nuestra torre fuerte a quien corremos.
Lord, if they're asking, Father, for healing,
si piden por sanidad,
spiritual,
espiritual,
physical,
físicamente,
Lord, whatever it may be, Lord, may you strengthen them.
Lo que sea, Señor, aliéntalos.
Lord, for the tithe and offering we're about to pick up also, Lord.
Ofrendas y los diezmos que estamos levantando.
We ask that you bless it, may you multiply it.
Pido que los bendigas y los multipliques.
Lord, may it be for the use of thy kingdom, Lord.
Que sea para el uso de tu reino.
Lord Jesus, we thank you.
Damos gracias.
We come in great expectations, Father.
Y venimos a la espera,
Señor. Our hearts are thirsting for more, Lord.
Nuestros corazones están sedientos,
Lord, fill your people, Lord.
Llena a tu gente.
We ask all these things in Jesus' name.
Pedimos esto en el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
Una iglesia sin mancha ni arruga, Él se llevará. Por lo tanto hay que estar preparados, llevará en las nubes, y en las nubes será nuestro encuentro con el Salvador. Y qué gozo, hijo, qué gozo yo siento en mi alma. Jesús mora en mí, es un gozo, hoy es un gozo tan grande que quiero servirle hasta el fin. Su palabra, hoy su palabra nos dice que el Hijo de Dios volverá. Oh, Él vendrá por su iglesia, qué dicha tan grande será. Amen, amen. Let's sing that song in the name of Jesus. Amen. Are we almost ready for the word? Amen. We have a triple header today. With this song, we'll be welcoming them. We have our brother Sammy. He'll be giving us the word. Brother Aaron and our brother Seth. Amen. Amen. Are you happy? Amen.
Oh, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Everybody, this fine evening.
Dios le bendiga en esta tarde.
While you guys are standing, if we could open up our Bibles to.
Estamos parados, podemos ir a nuestra Biblia.
To Colossians 2, 13 and 14.
A Colosenses 2, 13, 14.
And you can say amen when you have it. This
y puede decir amén cuando lo tenga.
And it reads, and you, being dead in your sins and the uncircumcision of your flesh, have he quickened together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses.
Y lee así, y a vosotros estando muertos en pecados y en la incircuncisión de vuestra carne, os dio vida juntamente con él, perdonándonos todos los pecados.
Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross.
Anulando el acta de los decretos que había contra nosotros, que no era contraria, quitándola de en medio y clavándola en la cruz.
You may all be seated.
Se pueden sentar, por favor.
So, if you guys don't know, myself, Seth, and Aaron, we're all youth helpers.
Ustedes saben. Yo, Ser y Aarón somos los ayudantes de la juventud.
And in youth, the topic that we've been discussing the past month or two.
Y con la juventud es algo que hemos estado discutiendo por algunos meses.
Is addictions.
Es las adicciones.
We've been talking about how there are many different types of addictions.
Hemos estado hablando de muchas diferentes tipos de adicciones.
And how to overcome these habits that we have.
Y cómo vencer estos hábitos que tenemos.
How these addictions become an idol.
Cómo estas adicciones vienen a convertirse en ídolos.
And because these habits that we have in our life, we become idol.
Y por estos hábitos que tenemos en vida, esos se pueden convertir en nuestros ídolos.
And the more and more that we get into it, I start to realize one thing.
Y lo más que nos adentramos, he llegado a esta cosa.
There's only one true way to overcome an addiction or a bad habit that you have.
Solamente hay una manera que podemos vencer esta adicción o estos hábitos que tenemos.
And the way of overcoming that is through Him who made it all possible.
Y la única manera que lo podemos hacer es a través de Él que hace todo posible.
Romans 8:37, if you guys want to turn to your Bibles.
Podemos voltear a nuestra Biblia en Romanos 8:37.
It says, we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us.
Somos más que conquistadores en Él que nos amó.
And thinking about this topic, it takes me back to a lot of things that I struggled with growing up as a young person.
Y pensando en este sujeto me trae atrás de como era joven.
That I struggled with.
Que yo batallaba con eso.
And even after I gave my heart to the Lord, there were still things that I found myself struggling with on the inside.
Y inclusive después que le di mi corazón al Señor, todavía batallo. Batallaba con algunas cosas.
Time and time again, I try to overcome these things, but I tried doing it my own way.
Vez tras vez, trataba de vencer esto, pero yo lo quería hacer a mi manera.
I've heard Jesus Christ died for me on the cross. I've heard that He's resurrected.
Yo oí que Jesús murió en la cruz y que resucitó.
But this was just all literature for me at that point.
Y esto era nomás como un escritura.
And I believe, you know, maybe everybody goes through that sometime in their life. It's just something that you hear at church.
Y todos podemos ir a través de eso.
Until it becomes a personal experience to you.
Hasta que viene a ser algo personal en nosotros.
Oh, I was that person that I would mess up and...
Yo era esa persona que batallaba.
You know, Jesus died for me, it's okay.
Y que Jesús era bien para mí.
I was that person.
Yo era esa persona.
But then you start to understand that Brother Brown says, you make grace a disgrace.
Amen. Y vine a entender que hermano Brennan decía que tú eres gracia para venir a encontrar gracia. Hace la gracia la desgracia.
And I was that person. I'm preaching to myself.
Y yo era esa persona y yo me predicaba a mí mismo.
So as I'm studying, I asked myself, have I ever truly thought?
Y mientras estudiaba, pensaba que realmente he pensado
what Jesus Christ did for me.
Lo que ha hecho Jesucristo en mí.
Have ever put myself in His shoes?
Me he puesto yo mismo en sus zapatos.
Our pastor's been hitting on to be like Jesus the past few months, right?
Como el pastor lo ha dicho, ser como Jesús en los pasados mensajes.
Do I really know what it is to be like Jesus?
Realmente sé lo que es ser como Jesús.
So I started studying the last 36 hours of the life of Jesus Christ.
Y empecé a estudiar las 36 últimas horas de Jesús.
And I'm going to put myself in His shoes this evening.
Y me voy a poner en sus zapatos en esta tarde.
In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus experienced that.
En el jardín de Getsemaní, Jesús experimentó
something that no one else has experienced before.
Algo que nadie había experimentado antes.
And there's a medical term for what he experienced.
Es un término médico que alguien experimentaba.
And the word is hematidrosis.
Y la palabra es hematidrosis.
This is a condition where the capillary or the blood vessel.
Esta es la condición de los vasos vasculares.
That surrounds the sweat gland.
Que está en las glándulas que sudan.
It's under so much pressure that it ruptures. It explodes.
Está bajo mucha presión que da mucha comezón y explota.
And the body begins to sweat blood.
Y el cuerpo viene a ser como una glándula sudorosa.
I believe Jesus Christ knew what was coming.
Yo sé que Jesucristo sabía lo que venía.
The night that he was taken captive, he was betrayed by someone that was close to him.
La noche que fue cautivo, vino a ser traicionado por alguien que estaba cerca de él.
It was someone that sat at the table to eat with him.
Era alguien que estaba en la mesa con él.
He was then put in cuffs.
Y le pusieron las esposas.
And he was forced to walk.
Y fue forzado a caminar.
To the high priest's house.
O a la casa del alto del alto sacerdote,
to Herod's,
de Herodes,
to Pilate's,
de Poncio Pilato.
And I was thinking about this, and I don't think the cuffs really hurt him that much.
Yo pensé, estas esposas no le lastimaron mucho.
But I think knowing that one of his friends betrayed him hurt him.
Pero sabía que alguien de sus amigos lo había traicionado.
Has anyone here ever been betrayed by a friend?
Alguien aquí que ha sido traicionado por algún amigo.
I'm sure most of us have.
Yo creo que muchos de nosotros hemos sido.
How many have ever betrayed a friend?
¿Cuántos hemos sido traicionados por un amigo?
You might say, well, I'm not that kind of person, Brother Sammy.
Usted puede decir, yo no soy esa clase de persona, hermano Sammy.
But how many times does the Lord ask us to do something and we don't do it?
¿Cuántas veces el Señor nos ha preguntado para hacer algo y nosotros no lo hacemos?
Instead of doing what he says, we look to our addiction or our bad habit.
En lugar de hacer lo que tenemos que hacer por él, hacemos nuestras adicciones y hábitos.
Soon after that, Jesus was taken to be scourged.
Antes que eso.
Después.
Después.
Jesus was taken to be scourged or whipped.
Fue llevado a ser latigado.
Now this was such a humiliating punishment that it was only meant for slaves and traitors. This was such a humiliating punishment.
Era una grande humillación.
It was only intended for slaves and traitors.
Que nada más eran por los esclavos y traidores.
Now I want you guys to picture Jesus at this time.
Y ustedes pueden poner en la foto a Jesús en este tiempo.
He was dressed completely naked.
Estaba completamente desnudo.
He was tied to a post.
Estaba amarrado a un poste.
With a large crowd gathered around him to watch. With a large crowd gathered around him to watch.
Con mucha gente alrededor.
Con mucha gente alrededor que lo miraban.
He was whipped from the back of his neck to the bottom of his ankles.
Fue latigado de atrás de su cuello hasta sus tobillos.
Now, and the people that were whipping Jesus, they were big in stature.
La gente que estaba latigando a Jesús.
They were big. They were big guys.
Grandes.
If you want to imagine something, imagine a pro NFL football player.
Usted se imagina como alguien que juega fútbol americano.
And each whip had 9 cattails or 9 pieces of 9 strands of leather.
Y cada latigazo tenía como 9 tiras de piel.
At the end of each cattail there was a weight.
Al final de cada tira tenía un
peso.
And up and down the strand,
y de abajo arriba de la tira,
there was a piece of sheep bone or cattle bone that was very sharp.
Había un pedazo de hueso que estaba muy filoso.
So when this big man would go and whip Jesus,
cuando puede decir un hombre grande le estaba latigando a Jesús,
the weight would sink deep into his skin, allowing the sharp pieces to pull back any flesh that it caught onto.
El latigazo traspasaba hasta su piel y cuando lo sacaban, sacaban pedazos de su piel.
Now, I've always asked myself, why did he go through this? And I know that he went through this because his stripes are what healed us.
Yo me preguntaba por qué él fue por todo eso.
I know that it was his stripes that healed us.
Y yo sé que por sus heridas, nosotros fuimos sanados.
But the Romans had another purpose of scourging Jesus.
Pero los romanos tenían otra
purpose of scourging Jesus. The purpose of them doing this to him was that so his muscle would be exposed.
El propósito que hacían eso era para que sus músculos fueran expuestos.
So that when he was on the cross, the birds would come and peck at his flesh.
Porque cuando él estaba en la cruz,
los pájaros,
they would come and peck at his flesh.
Podían venir y picar en su carne.
Now, the trauma that Jesus was going through this time was tremendous.
El drama, cuando Jesús vino esto, era tremendo.
I could picture him there, kneeling on the stump.
Yo me lo imagino ahí.
And I was thinking in my room yesterday night.
Y estaba yo pensando en mi cuarto.
And I started to feel what he felt. His hands were probably just convulsing from all the pain that he had.
Y yo estaba ahí pensando cómo sus manos estaban ahí.
From there, they take Jesus and they give him a crown of thorns.
De ahí, llevaron a Jesús y le dieron una corona de espinas.
Now each thorn was about 2 inches long.
Cada espina era como de 2 pulgadas.
They placed it on his head.
La pusieron en su cabeza.
And with a reed or with a stick.
Y sobre una.
With a stick.
Palo.
They would jab each thorn into his head to make sure it was in there
estaba
securely.
Picando en su cabeza que, para que estuvieran seguros que estaba bien clavado.
Now at this point, he's about to be crucified.
A este punto,
he's going to be crucified.
Iba a ser crucificado.
But I want you to imagine Jesus.
Pero quiero que se imagine que Jesús,
all the pain and suffering that he's already went through.
De todo el dolor y el sufrimiento que pasó.
His face was probably swollen shut by this time.
Su cara estaba muy hinchada para este tiempo.
He's probably very thirsty.
Yo creo que estaba muy sediento.
His lips were probably as dry as paper.
Sus labios estaban muy secos.
So they take him and they give him what is called the cross.
Se lo llevaron y le dieron lo que era llamado la cruz.
And I've already explained to you what they did when they scourged him.
Y ya les expliqué lo cuando le hicieron cuando le pegaron.
Yes. At this point, they give him a crossbar which was accustomed to the Romans.
A este punto,
they give him the crossbar to hold on.
Le dieron una cruz, una barra.
But this large piece of wood wasn't a piece of wood that you find at Lowe's or Home Depot.
Pero esta madera no era una madera que usted puede encontrar en el Lowe's o en el Home Depot.
They made sure this was the nastiest piece of wood that they could find.
Era una pieza, una parte de madera muy asquerosa que.
This wood was full of splinters.
Estaba lleno de
splinters, espinas.
Astillas.
And he had to carry it across his back that was already beaten to a pulp.
Y tenía que cargar esa cruz en su espalda.
Not only did he carry it on his back through the city. Not only did he carry it on his back through the city.
No solamente la cargó en su espalda por la ciudad.
But remember, he had to do it completely naked.
Pero recuerden que lo tenía que hacer completamente desnudo.
When he gets to the place where they're going to put him up on the cross.
Cuando llegaron al punto donde tenían que ponerlo en la cruz.
The Romans have to drive nails through his wrists and through his feet.
Los romanos tuvieron que clavar clavos a través de sus pies y sus manos.
And these Romans were smart. They knew what they were doing.
Estos romanos eran inteligentes. Ellos sabían lo que iban a hacer.
They knew that they could drive a nail through a man's wrist.
Ellos sabían que podían clavar un clavo sobre la muñeca.
Without hitting an artery.
No pegando ninguna arteria.
But hitting what's called the plantar nerve.
Pero pegando lo que es llamado
a nerve.
Un nervio.
And this nerve sent shockwaves through your body.
En este nervio. No lo,
it sent a lot of pain through your body.
Es mucho dolor a través de tu cuerpo.
So here is Jesus hanging on the cross.
Aquí está Jesús colgado en la cruz.
Where he wasn't able to breathe.
Que no estaba respirando.
Every time he had something to say.
Cada vez que tenemos algo que decir.
He had to pull his body up from the position that he was in.
Tenía que levantar su cuerpo hacia arriba.
To speak.
Para hablar.
And the words that he said on the cross.
Y las palabras que dijo en la cruz.
Were very special to me personally.
Y son muy especiales para mí personalmente.
There were three words that he said.
Eran tres palabras que dijo.
The three words he said was, "It is finished."
Y las tres palabras que dijo Elsa, consumado es.
And I was thinking about that, and
y estaba pensando en eso.
And I thought, what does that mean to me that it is finished?
¿Y qué significa esto para mí que consumado es?
And I could hear him telling me in my heart.
Y yo lo oía diciéndome en mi corazón.
Don't worry, Sam.
No, no te preocupes, Sam.
I paid the sin debt for you.
I
paid the sin debt for you.
Yo pagué esa deuda por ti.
You can make it now. You have an opportunity to get there.
Tú la puedes hacer. Tú tienes una oportunidad de estar ahí.
Well, I thank the Lord and
le agradezco a Dios.
I'm here to tell you tonight, if you're struggling with something,
y si usted está batallando con algo,
all you have to do is accept that sacrifice.
Es solamente aceptar el sacrificio.
And let the faith be your victory.
Y sea la fe su victoria.
Falling in love with Jesus Christ is the best thing that you could do.
Enamórese de Cristo es lo mejor que puede hacer.
And if I can leave you guys with one thing, I want to read a quote from Brother Branham.
Y si los puedo dejar con un extracto del hermano Branham.
He says, "Do you see it?
Lo puedes mirar.
Don't look at yourself.
No mires a ti.
Look at your sacrifice.
Mira tu sacrificio.
God don't look at you.
Dios no mira a ti.
He looks at your sacrifice, which is Christ.
Él mira tu sacrificio, el cual es Cristo.
Don't look at yourself.
No te mires a ti.
I'm not worthy.
Yo no soy digno.
You're not worthy.
Pues tú no eres digno.
Nobody's worthy.
Nadie es digno.
But he is the one.
Yeah. Pero él es.
I'm not counting on what I've done.
Sin saber lo que he hecho.
What I am.
Lo que soy.
I'd never make it.
Yo nunca lo hubiera hecho.
But I'm looking to what he done.
Pero yo miro a lo que él ha hecho.
There's where I'm trusting.
Yeah. Es en lo que tengo confianza.
He's my sacrifice.
Él es mi sacrificio.
I'm not worthy of healing.
Yo no soy digno de sanidad. No, señor.
I ought to have died long ago.
Yo tengo una man.
I ought to have died long ago. I've never been born.
Nunca he nacido.
But I live. I got eternal life.
Pero he vivido. Tengo vida eterna.
I'm going to heaven. Why?
Yo voy a al cielo. ¿Por qué?
Because he done it for me.
Porque él lo ha hecho por mí.
He was the one, he took my place.
Yeah. Él era el que tomó mi lugar.
And I thank the Lord for that this evening. He's been very gracious to us.
Y le agradezco al Señor en esta tarde que ha sido muy precioso para nosotros.
God bless you guys.
Dios les bendiga. Amen.
Amen. How many can give one to the Lord?
Amen.
You all stand with me. Let us read from God's sacred word, Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, and today, and forever.
Amen.
I believe the Lord's here, and he's going to do something great.
You
all can be seated.
Si pueden tomar sus asientos.
Now we just heard Brother Sam very thoroughly describe what happened to our Lord Jesus.
Escuchamos a nuestro hermano Sam describir lo que pasó con el Señor Jesús.
What I want to ask you tonight is, what are you doing about that?
Le quiero preguntar, ¿qué está haciendo usted al respecto?
We know he gave his life.
Sabemos que él dio su vida.
He was beaten.
Le golpearon.
All for us.
Todo por nosotros.
But what is our life showing tonight?
Pero ¿qué está mostrando nuestra vida?
You know, I want to tell you a little story.
Le quiero contar una historia.
And I wasn't going to even go this route, but I believe that's what the Lord's putting on my heart.
No iba a entrar en esto, pero es lo que el Señor puso en mi corazón.
You know, one time there was a man in the Bible named Shamgar.
Había un hombre en la Biblia que se llamaba Shamgar.
And all Shamgar knew all his life.
Lo que Shamgar sabía en su vida.
From the time he was a little boy.
Desde que era un muchacho.
Is that the Philistines would come.
Venían los filisteos.
His father would labor.
Su padre trabajaba.
He would raise up the crops.
Levantaba la cosecha.
Nurture them.
Los nutría.
Everything was perfect.
Todo estaba perfecto.
But there was one thing.
Pero había una cosa.
Every year the Philistines would come.
Cada año venían los filisteos.
And they would take what they wanted from them.
Y les quitaban lo que ellos querían.
It didn't matter how hard he worked.
No importaba qué tanto trabajaban.
His kids were starving.
Sus niños estaban hambrientos.
They had hardly any clothes on their back.
No tenían ropa sobre su espalda.
But yet the Philistines would come.
Pero venían los filisteos.
And they'd say, oh, nice crops you got this year.
Y decían, qué bonitas cosechas tienen este año.
Looks like we're going to be eating pretty good.
Vamos a comer bien.
And they would just take what they wanted.
Y se robaban lo que ellos querían.
So one day, Brother Branham says.
Un día dice el hermano Branham.
Shamgar was there in his home.
Shamgar estaba ahí en su hogar.
And he had worked all year getting his harvest ready.
Había trabajado todo el año preparando su cosecha.
Brother Branham says he had everything stacked in the barn.
El hermano Branham dice tenía todo almacenado.
And he's leaning there talking to his wife.
Y está ahí hablando con su esposa.
There she is. We worked hard for all year.
Ahí está todo. Trabajamos muy duro este año.
That's what we're going to harvest. That's our harvest.
Esta es nuestra cosecha.
But all of a sudden he hears some hoof prints coming.
De repente oye pasos de caballo.
And his heart sunk.
Y su corazón bajó al piso.
He remembered.
Y se recordó.
The Philistines are on their way.
Vienen los filisteos.
And he began to get real nervous, Brother Branham says.
El hermano Branham dice, se puso muy nervioso.
Started to pace back and forth.
Empezó a hacer pasos de un lado al otro.
What am I going to do?
Dice, ¿qué voy a hacer?
You guys have swords.
Tienen espadas.
You're so,
600 of these guys.
Son 600 hombres.
Brother Branham says he was just a judge, a little humble judge in where he lived.
El hermano Branham dice era un juez humilde en la ciudad donde él vivía.
He wasn't no trained soldier or warrior.
Él no estaba entrenado para batalla.
Brother Branham says he looked at his little children.
El hermano Branham dice miró hacia sus hijos.
I just began to think of my son Micah.
Y yo empecé a pensar en mi hijo Micah.
My daughter Adley.
En mi hija Abby.
Looking up at me with their face all full of dirt.
Mirándome a mí con sus caras llenas de tierra.
Their bellies all swollen out, haven't eaten.
Con sus vientres no habían comido.
Then I saw my wife Abby look at me.
Y miré a mi esposa que me miró.
And her dress was all torn up.
El vestido roto.
And they're looking at me as the head of the house.
Y me miran a mí como la cabeza del hogar.
What are you going to do about it, Dad?
¿Qué vas a hacer al respecto, papá?
Are you just going to let these guys come in and steal what God gave us?
¿Vas a dejar que entren y nos quiten lo que nos dio el Señor?
And Brother Branham said that he got angry.
El hermano Branham dice que se enojó.
He didn't have time to go train himself how to fight.
No tuvo tiempo de ir para entrenar.
He didn't have time to do anything.
No tuvo tiempo de hacer esas cosas.
But he got angry.
Pero se enojó.
And he remembered.
Y se recordó.
That he was an Israelite.
Él era un israelita.
Remembered that he had been circumcised.
Recordó que había sido circuncidado.
And he looked to his corner of his house.
Miró la esquina de su casa.
And he saw an ox goad.
Y miró la... An ox goad. La dejada de un buey.
And it's just a big piece of wood with a big piece of brass at the end.
Es un palo con un pedazo de bronce al.
They use it to, you know, herd cattle through the gate and whatnot.
Lo usan para guiar al ganado.
And so he grabbed the ox goad.
Agarró esta quijada del buey.
And the Holy Spirit came upon him.
Yeah. Y el Espíritu Santo vino sobre él.
Brother Branham says he jumped out of the window.
El hermano Branham dice salió de la ventana.
He went out and he slew over 600 men.
Y mató 600 hombres.
Trained soldiers.
Soldados entrenados.
And that's what God will do with us.
Es lo que hace el Señor con nosotros.
Whatever you have in your hand.
Lo que tiene en su mano.
Maybe it's your job.
Quizás sea su trabajo.
I know for me personally.
Personalmente.
I get to talk to many people from different walks of life.
Puedo hablar con mucha gente de diferentes caminos en la vida.
One minute I may be with an alcoholic.
Un día quizás esté con un alcohólico.
Next minute, I'm with an engineer.
El otro día con un ingeniero.
And you just get to see so many different walks of life and where the road led them.
Y miramos las caminatas de la vida donde la vida los ha dejado.
And one thing they all have in common.
Y lo que todos tienen en común.
Where did the time go?
¿Dónde ha ido el tiempo?
My life went so fast and here I'm in this nursing home.
Mi vida fue tan rápida y aquí estoy en este lugar.
I was a successful engineer at NASA.
Yo era un ingeniero en NASA.
Now fue nobody exitoso. Even comes to visit me.
Ahora nadie viene y me visita.
And so I was just thinking along those lines.
Pensando en estas cosas.
And if we could open our Bibles to John 8:10.
Si podemos abrir las escrituras en Juan 8:10.
And it reads, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Hath no man condemned thee?
Enderezándose Jesús y no viendo a nadie sino a la mujer, le dijo, mujer, ¿dónde están los que te acusaban? ¿Ninguno te condenó?
Verse 11.
Verso 11.
She said, no man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more.
Ella dijo, ninguno, Señor. Entonces Jesús le dijo, ni yo te condeno, vete y no peques más.
Now, Satan is the biggest accuser that I know of.
Satanás es el acusador más grande que yo conozco.
The Bible says he's there day and night.
La Biblia dice, él está ahí día y noche.
Accusing the brethren.
Acusando a los hermanos.
And so one day Jesus was teaching in the temple.
Un día Jesús enseñando en el templo.
And the scribes and Pharisees, they brought this woman that they caught in the act of adultery.
Los escribas y los fariseos trajeron a esta mujer que encontraron en adulterio.
And I could just see Jesus maybe talking to a couple of lowlifes that we would call.
Y quizás me imagino Jesús hablando con gente común que podríamos llamarle.
Maybe a couple of outcasts.
Quizás unos echados fuera.
When all of a sudden these scribes and Pharisees bring this woman in, maybe throw her on the floor.
Estos escribas y fariseos traen a esta mujer, quizás la tiran al piso.
Say, Jesus, look at this woman.
Diciendo, Jesús, mira esta mujer.
Caught her in the act of adultery.
La encontramos en el acto, en el mero acto.
You know what the law of Moses says?
¿Sabes lo que dice la ley de Moisés?
She's to be stoned.
Es de ser apedrada.
And my, the Bible says that Jesus, he just stooped down to the ground.
La Biblia dice que Jesús
just began writing in the sand.
Bajó al piso, empezó a escribir en la arena.
And I can just picture total chaos, all these men telling Jesus what she did and what she, this life she was living.
Me imagino un caos, estos hombres acusando a esta mujer de la vida que ella vivía.
But the Bible says Jesus knelt down and as if he didn't even hear the men, just began to write.
La Biblia dice Jesús se hincó como si no escuchara a estos hombres y empezó a escribir.
And I could just imagine him maybe doodling.
Y me imagino quizás dibujando algo.
Didn't really care what they had to say.
Quizás no le importaba lo que ellos decían.
Then he picks up his head again.
Levanta su cabeza.
They kept pressuring him. What are you going to do about it, Jesus? Because they wanted to condemn him. They wanted to accuse him.
Y con más presión diciendo, ¿qué vas a hacer al respecto, Jesús? La querían acusar.
Well, he who is without sin, go ahead and cast your stone. If that's what the law says, go ahead and do it.
Jesús dice, bueno, la ley dice, bueno, hay que apedrarle al que esté sin pecado, aviente la primera piedra.
The Bible says, one by one.
Uno por uno, dice la Biblia.
The accusers started to leave the room.
Los acusadores empezaron a irse.
Jesus just kept writing in the sand.
Y continuó escribiendo en la arena.
He picks up his head.
Levanta su cabeza.
All the accusers were gone.
Los acusadores se habían ido.
There in the middle of the room was this woman.
En medio de este cuarto con esta mujer.
And he asks her.
Y le pregunta.
Woman, where's your accusers?
Mujer, ¿dónde están los que te acusaban?
Who's them that condemn you?
¿Quién te ¿Dónde están los que te condenaban?
I don't condemn you.
Yo no te condeno.
But he says, go.
Pero dice, ve.
Sin no more.
Y no peques más.
And I believe that's where we make the mistake many times.
Yo creo es donde hacemos el error muchas veces.
You know, adultery.
El adulterio.
It's a voluntary act.
Es un acto voluntario.
It's someone who's married.
Es alguien que está casado.
Being with somebody who's not their husband.
Estando
or wife, spouse.
Alguien que no es su pareja.
So this woman knew what she was doing.
Esta mujer sabía lo que hacía.
You might say, well, brother, I've never done that to my spouse.
Y quizás diga, hermano, yo no he hecho eso a mi esposa o esposo.
Or maybe young people here might say, well, I'm not even married. That don't apply to me.
O unos jóvenes quizás digan, yo no estoy casado. Eso no aplica
well,
para
that's
mí.
That's good.
Eso está bien.
But there's something called spiritual adultery.
Pero hay algo que se llama adulterio espiritual.
And it's when you live a life of the world.
Es cuando vive una vida del mundo.
Claiming to be a Christian.
Clamando ser cristiano.
We whore around on the Lord. We mess around on the Lord.
Estamos jugando con el Señor.
His word says, don't do this.
Su palabra dice, no hagas esto.
We think we're the exception to the rule. We do it anyway.
Pensamos que somos la excepción de la regla y lo hacemos de todos modos.
We lie, we cheat our way through life.
Mentimos, hacemos trampa durante la vida.
We break our vows to him.
Rompemos nuestros votos hacia él.
We forget all he's done for us.
Se nos olvida todo lo que él ha hecho.
It makes me think of a young couple.
Me recuerda de una pareja.
When they first start dating.
Cuando primero empezaron amistad.
They can stay on the phone for all night, 12 hours.
Estaban por teléfono toda la noche.
Everything's so brand new. Everything's so good and well-maintained at that point.
Todo era nuevo. Estaba bueno y buen mantenido.
And as life hits us.
Y nos pega la vida.
And reality sets in.
Entra la realidad.
We start to grow further and further apart.
Y nos apartamos más y más y más.
So is it with the Lord Jesus.
Así es con el Señor.
We go through some trials of life.
Entramos en pruebas de la vida.
We think he's forgotten about us.
Pensamos que él se ha olvidado de nosotros.
But all along he's in the middle of the room.
Pero él está ahí en medio del cuarto.
Saying, I didn't condemn you of anything.
Diciendo, yo no te condeno.
Just like those scribes and Pharisees, your own conscience condemned you.
Como los escribas y los fariseos, tu conciencia te condena.
And then that's when Satan comes to us.
Y es cuando viene Satanás.
He's a great accuser.
El gran acusador.
He always comes at your weakest moment.
Él viene a tu momento más débil.
And he's coming not just to accuse you.
Y no viene solo para acusarte.
But he's coming to impregnate you with a seed.
Pero para preñarte con una simiente.
Get you to commit adultery against God's word.
Para que cometa adulterio contra la palabra de Dios.
And he gets this seed of a lie.
Y tiene esta simiente de mentira.
Maybe he'll tell you, hey, you should run away from home.
Quizás le diga, te diga, debes correr de la casa.
Hey, this message is false.
Este mensaje es falso.
This word of God, it's just a bunch of history.
Esta palabra de Dios solo son historias.
You don't belong here.
No perteneces aquí.
And you opened your womb to that.
Y usted ha abierto su vientre para esto.
And he deposits his seed in your mind.
Él deposita su simiente en tu mente.
And he's very patient.
Él es muy paciente.
You don't need something to happen right away.
Él no necesita que algo acontezca en el momento.
He'll put you around the wrong people.
Pero lo pone con la gente equivocada.
The ones who are going to influence and water that seed.
Con la gente que van a regar esta simiente.
Because he knows if he can get you under that right environment.
Si él lo puede poner en ese ambiente correcto o ese ambiente apropiado.
You'll produce something.
Él va a producir algo.
And that's what he wants to do. He wants to impregnate us with his lies.
Nos quiere preñar con sus mentiras.
Brother Branham says that's exactly what Eve done.
El hermano Branham dice es lo que hizo Eva.
With a spiritual intercourse.
Con un acto espiritual.
First that come by believing Satan's lie.
Primero creyendo la mentira de Satanás.
Into the womb of her mind.
En el vientre de su mente.
That polluted her soul.
Que contaminó su alma.
Set death in the soul.
Entró muerte a su alma.
Then the natural act taken place.
Y luego aconteció el acto natural.
That's all Satan has to do. You don't have to get you to go and smoke and drink and this and no. You don't even have to kill you.
Es lo que hace Satanás. No tiene que llevarlo a tomar o a fumar.
He'll just get you so cold and indifferent.
Lo pone tan frío, tan indiferente.
You'd probably be better off dead.
Quizás sería mejor muerto.
And that's what he did.
Y es lo que hizo.
He'll just put these ideas in your head and the next thing to do is just to follow through with it.
Pondrá estas ideas en su mente y luego va a hacer este acto.
And he says, and when the bride of Jesus Christ lets man-made creeds and dogmas,
cuando la novia de Jesucristo cree estos dogmas de hombre,
take the place of God,
cuando estas cosas toman el lugar de Dios,
she's committing adultery.
Ella está cometiendo adulterio.
Then he says, she let this come into her mind.
Ella dejó que esto entrara a su mente.
She was willing.
Ella estaba dispuesta.
And so are we many times.
Y muchas veces nosotros también.
The Lord gets us out of our condition.
El Señor nos saca de nuestra condición.
We're fired up for a little while.
Estamos en fuego por un poco de
tiempo. Just like all those in Shamgar's day.
Y igual como los hombres en el día de Shamgar.
We let Satan come right in.
No, nos dejamos que Satanás entre.
It's not that God's not blessing us.
No es que el Señor no nos está bendiciendo.
It's that we don't know how to maintain our blessings.
Pero no sabemos mantener nuestras bendiciones. Él entra.
And just like that vision Brother Diego had where he was in a factory just taking things that he needed.
Como en la visión del hermano Diego estaba en una bodega tomando las cosas que él necesitaba.
Healings, blessings, limbs.
Sanidades, bendiciones, brazos o piernas.
Just as quick as you get them, Satan's already grabbing them out of your cart before you leave that factory.
Cuando usted lo obtiene, Satanás ya está queriendo quitarle eso.
And so it brings me to the question, who do we think we are?
Venimos a la pregunta, ¿quiénes pensamos que somos?
Who do we think we are?
¿Quiénes pensamos que nosotros somos?
When we have the best here.
Cuando tenemos lo mejor.
God's given us his word.
Dios nos ha dado su palabra.
He sheltered us through all this pandemic, through all we've gone through.
Nos ha protegido por esta pandemia.
And who do we think we are to get the word and throw it to the dump?
¿Quién pensamos que somos tomar esta palabra y tirarla?
Shame on us if we think that.
Vergüenza nos daría.
We'll be held accountable for what we've been doing.
Vamos a ser dependibles de esas cosas.
And I'm talking to the youth tonight.
Responsables.
You all know better.
Hablo con la juventud.
Shame on you.
Vergüenza nos debe de dar.
We have a great example here, our pastor.
Tenemos un gran ejemplo, nuestro pastor.
The ministry.
El ministerio.
Where do we learn these things?
¿Dónde aprendemos estas cosas?
I know it hasn't been here.
No ha sido en este lugar.
Someone else has been speaking to you.
Alguien más ha estado hablando con usted.
And I didn't... The parents too.
Los padres también.
We got to raise a standard.
Tenemos que levantar un
estándar. We're either going to waste our time trying to be successful.
Estándar, no perder el tiempo.
Or we're just going to let the enemy come in and take our youth one by one.
Dejando el diablo que nos quite nuestra
juventud. That's what he's doing. I hate to break it to you, but that's what he's doing.
Es lo que él está haciendo.
But who's going to stand up tonight?
Pero ¿quién se va a parar en esta
noche? Just going to let it be another service?
¿Va a ser otro servicio más?
Or is somebody going to stand up about it?
¿O alguien se va a parar?
I know I will.
Yo sé que yo lo haré.
I don't want to see another youth be lost.
No quiero ver otro joven ser perdido.
I don't want to see anybody be lost.
No quiero ver que nadie esté perdido.
But that's why Brother Branham says we fight our way to hell.
Dice el hermano Branham, peleamos nuestro camino hacia el infierno.
God does everything to get us in his path.
Dios hace todo para mantenernos en su camino.
No matter how much he wants it for us.
No importa cuánto él lo quiera para nosotros.
How much our parents might want it for us.
Quizás cuánto nuestros padres quieran.
How much our children might want it for us.
O nuestros hijos lo
quieran. We gotta want it for ourselves as well. Yeah.
Lo tenemos que querer para nosotros mismos.
It's an emergency.
Es una emergencia.
Yeah. And that's where Shamgar was at.
Es donde estaba Shamgar.
A state of emergency.
Un estado de emergencia.
He didn't have time to figure out how this or that was gonna happen.
No tenía tiempo de averiguar cómo iba a pasar esto o lo otro.
He just went after what God had given him.
Él fue por lo que el Señor le había dado.
And we can't back down this evening.
No nos podemos retrasar.
Satan's
esta,
roaring like a lion.
Esta tarde, el diablo está como un león rugiente.
But he's a liar.
Él es un mentiroso.
Nothing but a bluff.
Es un fanfarrón.
Sure, we're going to make mistakes.
Vamos a hacer errores.
We're going to do things maybe we shouldn't do.
Quizás hagamos cosas que no deberíamos hacer.
But just as Jesus told that woman.
Pero así como Jesús le dijo a esta mujer.
Go and sin no more.
Ve y no peques más.
That's the key.
Esa es la clave.
Believe on the Lord.
Cree en el Señor.
Don't fight amongst one another.
No peleen entre uno y los otros.
I know it's easy right now. I see it. There's so much pressure built up.
Yo sé que es fácil ahorita. Hay tanta presión ahorita.
We should understand one another.
Pero hay que entender uno al otro.
Everybody sees this pandemic in a different way.
Todos ven esta pandemia en una manera diferente.
Maybe I'm a little more lax than the person sitting next to me.
Quizás yo sea un poco más relajado que la persona.
It doesn't mean they're right or I'm wrong.
Alrededor, pero no significa que ellos están mal o bien.
Lord, help me to just respect this person. Yeah.
Señor, enséñame a respetar
That's
esta
all we
persona.
Have to do. We don't have to fight and squabble about everything.
No tenemos que pelear sobre todo.
We've got to come together.
Yeah. Pero venir juntos.
We need the elders. We need to come together.
Venir juntos.
We need the elders.
Necesitamos a los ancianos.
You all have a lot to show the younger children.
Tenemos mucho que enseñar a los jóvenes.
We need the married couples to show the newlyweds how to act.
Los ya casados de tiempo enseñar a los parejas jóvenes.
We're like a tight-knit community.
Una comunidad junta, apretada.
And we need to protect the young people. Put them in the center.
Proteger a los jóvenes.
Just like those yaks do when the wolves are coming.
Cuando,
like buffalo,
con el búfalo cuando vienen los lobos.
They get all the calves and they put them in the center.
Right. Ponen a las vacas, los ponen en el centro.
And they say, come on, wolves, we dare you.
Y dicen, vengan pa' acá, lobos.
That's what we have to do.
Es lo que tenemos que hacer.
But as long as the enemy gets us distracted,
cuando el enemigo nos distrae,
he'll do what he wants.
Él hará lo que él quiera.
We gotta be sober.
Tenemos que ser sobrios.
Vigilant.
Vigilantes.
Look out if we offended somebody.
Mira si ha ofendido a alguien.
That could be the very reason they don't come back.
Quizás sea la razón por la que no regresen.
Watch your words.
Mire sus palabras.
Watch your actions.
Sus acciones.
God bless you.
Dios les bendiga.
Would you open your Bibles to Mark?
Que abren sus Biblias a Marcos.
Mark 2, verse 1.
Marcos 2, 1.
And again he entered into Capernaum.
Entró Jesús otra vez a Capernaum.
After some days.
Después de algunos días.
And it was noise.
Y se oyó.
That he was in the house.
que estaba en casa.
May the Lord Jesus add his blessing to the reading of the word, and you may be seated. Why, my brothers before me, I'm so proud of them. It's a privilege to work with you, Brother Sam, Brother Aaron. Thank you for the letting the Lord use you.
Gracias por dejar el Señor usarlos.
It's also a great honor for me to address the bride of Jesus Christ.
Es un gran honor a dirigirme la novia de Jesucristo.
And thank you, Pastor, for the confidence
y gracias,
you have in
Pastor,
me.
Por la confianza.
But I believe.
Pero yo creo.
Can you believe tonight?
¿Pueden creer en esta noche?
Yes, amen.
That Jesus.
Que Jesús.
Is in the house.
Está en la casa.
I don't know if you can actually really believe that.
No sé si realmente pueden creer eso.
But tell your neighbor.
Dígale a su vecino.
Jesus.
Jesús.
Is in the house.
Está en casa.
Glory.
Is Jesus in this house
Jesús
tonight?
Jesús está en esta casa en esta noche.
Well, we'll get to there here in a bit.
Vamos a llegar ahí en un poco.
But as we describe, as the disciples describe in this scene.
Como los discípulos describieron en esta escena.
It tells you in that scripture, if you keep reading on,
dice en esa escritura, si mantiene leyendo,
that he came to the city of Capernaum,
vino a la ciudad de Capernaum,
near the Sea of Galilee,
junto el mar de Galileo.
And you see in the chapter before,
y mira en el capítulo antes,
Jesus was performing miracles.
Jesús estaba haciendo milagros.
He was casting out demons.
Estaba echando fuera demonios.
He was healing the sick.
Estaba sanando los enfermos.
He even told Peter to cast his net upon the water.
Y le dijo a Pedro que ponga la red sobre el agua.
In so much that his fame started to spread across Galilee.
Y su fama comenzó a separarse ahí por la ciudad.
So it wasn't a secret if he heard Jesus was coming.
No era secreto si usted escuchaba que Jesús venía.
Of course, everybody wants to be there, right?
Todos quieren estar
ahí. Don't you want to be there?
¿Quién no quieren estar allí?
And so he had to actually start sneaking into cities.
Él tenía que ir muy cuidadosamente entrar en ciudades.
Otherwise, he's going to be ambushed by a big crowd.
Porque iba a ser embuscado por toda la gente.
But one day he comes into the city of Capernaum.
Un día entra a la ciudad de Capernaum.
And he meets at a house.
Y viene a un lugar.
And let's say it's John's house.
Y vamos a decir que era la casa de Juan.
And as he was talking to John and the people that are there around him,
mientras él hablaba con Juan y la gente alrededor de él,
maybe his mom and his dad,
quizás su mamá y su papá,
maybe a couple other friends,
quizás unos amigos,
the neighbors start getting wind.
Los vecinos comenzaron a escuchar.
Oh, Jesus is in the house? Who's that preaching?
¿Jesús está en la casa? ¿Es él predicando?
And word started to spread.
Y la palabra comenzó a correr.
Jesus is in the house. You better go to John's house.
Jesús está en la casa de Juan.
Come on, we're going to go get fed.
Vamos a ser alimentados.
And it says that they came out of every town of Galilee.
Dicen que salieron de todas las ciudades de Galilea.
In Judea.
En Judea.
In Jerusalem.
Jerusalén.
Why, that must have been a pretty big crowd.
Quizá era mucha gente.
And eventually the streets and the markets were empty.
Y las calles y los mercados estaban vacíos.
Even the Pharisees and the doctors of law were there.
Aún los fariseos y los doctores de la ley estaban allí.
But I want you to know
quiero que sepan
that the power of the Lord was present to heal them.
Que el poder del Señor estaba allí presente para sanarlos.
And news of his presence
y la noticia de su presencia
traveled across the city
fue entre la ciudad
until it hit some great friends.
Hasta que llegó a unos gran amigos.
And one friend came unto his paralyzed friend.
Un amigo llegó a su otro amigo que estaba paralizado.
You see, this man couldn't walk.
Este hombre no podía andar.
He was definitely paralyzed in his legs.
Él estaba paralizado en las piernas.
And maybe ever since he was a child.
Quizá desde niño.
But many of us, isn't that many of us today?
¿Pero qué no es mucho de nosotros en este día?
Just like this man,
como este hombre,
he didn't know how to walk on the promises of God.
Él no
right
sabía
now
cómo caminar sobre las promesas del Señor.
And as he heard Brother Aaron minister,
como escuchamos hermano Aaron ministrar,
we do this to ourselves many times.
Hacemos esto a nosotros yeah mismos muchas veces.
Because we start off good with the walk with the Lord,
porque comenzamos muy bien con la caminata del Señor,
and we'd rather get tangled up in the things of this world.
Y a veces nos engañamos en las
and
cosas del
those
mundo.
Those things start to paralyze us.
Yeah. Esas cosas comienzan a paralizarnos.
But one said unto them,
uno le dijo a ellos,
you wouldn't believe what I just saw.
No vas a creer lo que acabo de ver.
I saw Jesus touching a leper.
Vi a Jesús a tocar a un leproso.
And he was made whole.
Y fue sanado.
They started to preach to him.
Y comenzó a predicar.
Another said,
otro dijo,
he's just at John's house.
Y pues está en la casa de Juan.
We have to go see him.
Tenemos que ir a verlo.
And as that man, the paralyzed man,
y como ese hombre que estaba paralizado,
as he's getting fed,
él está siendo alimentado,
it wasn't a choice of whether they were going or not.
Él no era escogimiento si íbamos a ir o no.
They were taking him.
Lo iban a llevar.
Because they believed on the Lord.
Porque creían en el
they
Señor.
Were waiting for this promise.
Estaban esperando esta promesa.
And he must have remembered something.
Y quizás se recordó de él.
He must have said,
y dijo,
I think my mom told me something of, bless the Lord.
Yo creo que mi mamá me dijo que algo como bendecir al Señor.
Oh my soul.
Bendito sea el Señor, oh mi alma.
And forget not all his benefits.
Y no se recuerda.
Who forgiveth all thy iniquities.
De todos los beneficios que es perdonar tus iniquidades.
Who healeth all thy diseases.
Que sana todas tus enfermedades.
Who redeemeth thy life from destruction. Who crowneth thee. Who crowneth thee.
Que me corona.
With loving kindness.
Con
tender mercies. Tender mercies.
Y misericordias.
Oh, what great friends.
Okay, gran amigos.
That this man had.
Que tenía este hombre.
And they picked him up.
Lo levantaron.
Maybe this man weighed 200 pounds.
Quizá ese hombre pesaba 200 libras.
Maybe they had to travel a couple hours across the city.
Dice que tenían que viajar como dos horas en la ciudad.
Maybe it was several miles.
Quizá era muchas millas.
They didn't have no cars.
No tenían carros.
Not even a horse and buggy.
Ni carruaje ni caballo.
This was the first Brober. Brother Will. And they, a Brober, like a Uber, but your brother picks you up.
Ese era el primero que el amigo va y te levanta y te lleva.
And they picked him up.
Lo levantaron.
And they traveled.
Y viajaron.
With a purpose.
Con un propósito.
And they didn't complain how heavy he was.
No se quejaron qué tan pesado él estaba.
But their era. Faith was strong.
Pero su fe era fuerte.
They were determined to take him to Jesus.
Estaban determinados a llevarlo a Jesús.
They weren't only hearers of that word.
No nomás escuchaban la palabra.
But doers of the word.
Hacedores de la palabra.
Amen. And as they reached the crowd.
Y llegaron a la gente.
The disciples, maybe someone came, hey, what's going on? What are you doing?
Discípulos quizá dijeron, pues, ¿qué está haciendo? ¿Qué está pasando?
Oh, you don't understand. We got to see Jesus right now.
No entienden. Tenemos que ver a Jesús en este momento.
He's kind of busy. He's preaching right now.
Ocupado, está predicando ahorita.
We don't want you to mess with him right now.
No quieres que lo moleste ahorita.
And as one of them was thinking,
Uno estaba diciendo, pues,
maybe you come back another day.
Quizá venimos, regresamos otro día.
Oh, no.
No.
One of them said,
uno dijo,
might have been a little crazy.
Quizás era poco loco.
He says, we must see Jesus.
Tenemos que ver a Jesús, dijo.
I gotta see Jesus.
Yo tengo que ver.
Because I want to see a miracle happen.
Yo quiero ver un milagro acontecer.
And then said, well, the door's blocked.
Pues la puerta está cerrada, bloqueada.
He said, I know.
Yo sé, dijo.
We'll go through the roof.
Entramos por el techo.
And they started taking him up on the roof.
Y lo comenzaron a llevar por el techo.
And what they started to do,
y lo que comenzaron a hacer,
they started to tear the roof down.
Comenzaron a romper el
they started to break it apart.
Comenzaron a romper.
And as Jesus speaking, it Jesus interrupts him.
Hablando, lo capta su atención.
And they call out to him, Jesus.
Y llaman hacia él, Jesús.
We need you to heal our friend.
Necesitamos que sanes a nuestro
amigo. We know you can do it.
Sabemos que lo
puedes. We know who you are.
Sabemos quién eres.
We heard about you.
Escuchamos de ti.
And we're here tonight.
Y en esta noche.
Believing on this.
Creyendo en esto.
Wow. He said, your faith was beautiful.
Dijo, su fe es maravilloso, hermoso.
And when he saw their faith.
Yeah. Cuando él vio la fe de ellos.
He said to the sick of the palsy.
Le dijo al que estaba paralizado.
The paralyzed man that must have been paralyzed since birth.
El hombre que estaba paralizado quizá desde
since
un niño.
Since a child.
Desde un niño.
And all he had to say.
Todo lo que tenía que decir.
Was son.
Es hijo.
Thy sins.
Tus pecados.
Be forgiven thee.
Perdonados.
Well, praise the Lord.
Alabado sea el Señor.
Your sins will be forgiven you.
Tus pecados van a ser perdonados.
You need to believe and get in front of Jesus.
Tienen que creer y ponerse enfrente de Jesús.
But like anywhere else,
pero como cualquier otro lugar,
there's the unbelievers around.
Hay incrédulo que está
these
ahí.
These critics.
Los críticos.
And they, like Brother Aaron was describing, they wanted to get Jesus in a.
Como Aaron estaba describiendo, querían agarrar
in a pickle.
Que los querían poner en un lío.
And they were reasoning in their heart.
Y ellos estaban con duda en su
and
corazón.
And he catches them.
Y él lo capta.
And says, why did this man? And immediately Jesus perceived his spirit. That they were so reasoned within themselves.
Inmediatamente Jesús percibió el espíritu de ellos que estaban razonando dudas en su corazón.
Why reason ye these things in your heart?
¿Por qué dudas en tu corazón?
Whether is it easier to say?
¿Es más fácil decir?
Thy sins be forgiven thee?
¿Tus pecados son perdonados?
Or to say?
¿O para decir?
Arise.
Levántate.
I don't know if you can believe me this evening.
No sé si me pueden creer.
But I say unto you.
Les digo hoy.
You got to tell yourself, arise.
Se tiene que decir usted mismo.
Take up your bed.
Levántese, tome su cama.
And go thine way.
Y vaya su camino.
And he said that this whole, what was the purpose of this whole thing?
Digo, ¿qué es el propósito de todo esto?
He tells them that you may know.
Le dice para que usted, para que sepan.
That the Son of Man,
el Hijo del Hombre,
hath the power on earth to forgive sins.
Tiene el poder en la tierra para perdonar los pecados.
And he tells them again.
Y les dice de nuevo.
Arise.
Levántese. Yeah.
Arise.
Levántese. Yeah.
Take up your bed.
Tome su cama.
And go thy way into thy house.
Vaya a su camino, a la casa.
And as I can imagine,
yo puedo imaginar,
a little toe started to wiggle.
Quizá el dedito del pie se comenzó
maybe
a mover.
He started to get some strength in his legs.
Comenzó a agarrar fuerza a las piernas.
And someone maybe helped him up a little bit.
Alguien lo ayudó a levantarse un poco.
But as he stood on his two feet,
él se levantó en sus dos pies.
For the first time,
la primera vez,
he wasn't dependent on anybody else.
Ya no estaba dependiendo de alguien
más. But the Lord Jesus Christ.
Pero Jesús,
and he arose up. He rose up,
y se levantó,
took his bed,
tomó su cama,
and went before them all.
Y fue delante de todos.
In so much as they were all amazed and started glorifying God.
Todos comenzaron a glorificar.
Why? What would you do?
¿Qué hiciera usted?
If for the longest time you couldn't walk in the things of the Lord.
Si por mucho tiempo no pueden dar las casas,
and cosas he rescues you from your condition.
Y lo rescata de su condición.
What would you do with your two feet?
¿Qué hiciera con sus pies?
Would you dance around?
¿Usted danzara un poco?
Would you walk by faith?
¿Usted andara por fe?
You got to answer that for yourself.
Usted tiene que dar la respuesta por usted mismo.
But the same Lord Jesus.
El mismo Señor Jesús.
The same Lord Jesus.
El mismo Señor Jesús.
Come on, church. The same Lord Jesus.
El mismo Señor Jesús.
He was the same in our prophet's time.
Era el mismo en el tiempo de nuestro profeta.
Many that were lame.
Muchos estaban cojos.
Why? He told them to arise.
Pero les dijo, levántese.
Take up your bed.
Tome su cama.
Wheelchairs were brought in our founder's time.
Y también en el tiempo de nuestro pastor fundador.
And the same Lord Jesus was there.
El mismo Señor Jesús estaba allí.
Arise.
Levántese.
Take up your bed.
Tome su cama.
And I believe that's going to happen in our time.
Yo creo que eso va a acontecer en nuestro tiempo.
It's the same yesterday.
Es el mismo ayer.
Today.
Hoy.
And forever.
Por siempre.
I remember.
Te recuerdo.
The word of the Lord that came through Brother Diego.
La palabra que vino a través del hermano Diego.
He saw a vision of my brother.
Y vio una visión de mi hermano.
You see, my brother has cerebral palsy.
Mi hermano está paralítico en la mente, en el
cerebro. Though he's walked.
De parte, pero sí puede andar. Él sí puede andar.
He's not fully whole.
No está completo.
But I believe.
Yo creo.
That the word of God is true.
La palabra de Dios es verdadera.
And I say to you, my brother.
Y les digo, hermanos.
Because I love you with my whole heart.
Porque te amo con todo mi corazón.
I always love that brother.
Yo siempre he amado a ese hermano.
I believe that he's here tonight.
Yo creo que él está aquí en esta noche.
And I tell you, my brother.
Y le digo a mi hermano.
Don't give up hope.
No se rinda.
Keep believing.
Y mantenga creyendo.
He's the same here tonight.
Él es el mismo hoy en esta
noche. I say to you, my brother.
Les digo a mi hermano.
Arise.
Levántese.
Take up your bed.
Tome su cama.
And walk.
Y ande.
You see my brother that was here on Sunday?
¿Usted ve a mi hermano que estaba aquí el domingo?
What a blessing it was to see him worship the Lord.
Qué bendición era para verlo alabar al Señor.
And you may say, well, brother,
usted puede decir, pues, hermano,
I can walk. I am not paralyzed.
Yo puedo andar. Yo no estoy paralizado.
I am not physically paralyzed.
Físicamente no estoy paralizado.
Well, praise the Lord.
Alabado sea el Señor.
But what many don't realize,
lo que muchos no realizan,
that we are spiritually paralyzed.
Que espiritualmente estamos paralizados.
Our inner man is very weak. Cannot walk.
Nuestro hombre de interior está muy débil, no puede andar.
We get tangled with the things of the world.
Nos engañamos con las cosas del mundo.
And we forget to nurture this guy.
Y se nos olvida nutrir a este hombre.
Is it a coincidence we've been hearing nurturing the body, the spirit, and the soul?
¿Es coincidencia que hemos estado escuchando los mensajes nutriendo el cuerpo, alma, y el espíritu?
And if you don't give him the right nutrition,
si no lo nutra correctamente,
just like your physical body,
es como su cuerpo físico,
becomes very weak.
Comienza se debilita.
He's lethargic. He's lethargic.
Es como muy muy lento.
And he starts not being able to walk.
Y llega al lugar donde no puede andar.
Your faith muscles might become dormant over time.
Sus músculos de fe pueden ser
Let me rephrase that.
Muy débiles durante el tiempo.
Your faith muscles will become dormant.
Músculos de fe vienen a ser como dormidos, como.
And maybe you say you're okay without God.
Y quizá dice que está bien sin Dios.
And over time, you'll become dormant.
Y durante el tiempo va a ser.
You'll be start coming. Ah, I can't move so much.
Ya no se puede mover más.
I don't know if we should go to church.
No sé si deberíamos ir a la iglesia. No sé.
We'll just stay home.
Nos quedamos en casa.
But I tell this to help you.
Digo esto para ayudarles.
Because I was like this paralyzed man.
Porque yo estaba, yo era como este hombre paralizado, paralítico.
I forgot to nurture him.
Yo se me olvidó nutrirlo.
Shame on me.
Vergüenza en mí.
I was struggling and warring in my own mind.
Yo estaba peleando en mi propia mente.
Struggling with my own complexes.
Con mis propios complejos.
Rather listening to the devil.
Escuchando al diablo.
Than to what Jesus says about me.
En lugar de escuchar de
Dios. I wasn't feeding myself.
No me estaba nutriendo correctamente.
And a few weeks ago.
Y hace unas semanas atrás.
Maybe longer.
Quizá un poco más tiempo.
I was praying unto the Lord.
Estaba orando al Señor.
Thinking I was in an Indian death walk.
Pensando que yo estaba en una caminata de los indios en un círculo.
Asking the Lord, help me to overcome myself.
Y pidiendo al Señor, ayúdame a vencerme yo mismo.
I want you to have preeminence in my life.
Quiero que tengas preeminencia en mi vida.
But I'm desperate this time.
Pero soy desesperado en este
momento. I need you, Lord.
Te necesito, Señor.
And I didn't think of it, anything of it.
No pensé mucho de respecto.
But I came on Wednesday, just like tonight.
Vine el miércoles, así como esta noche.
I'm in the audio room.
Estaba en el cuarto del audio.
And a friend came to me.
Y un amigo vino a mí.
And he says, God bless you, my brother.
Y me dijo, Dios le bendiga, mi hermano.
Oh, God bless you, brother Diego.
Oh, Dios le bendiga, hermano Diego.
And he says, yeah, so I am preaching tonight. And I'm preaching tonight.
Voy a predicar esta noche.
Okay, yeah, we'll get you your audio stuff. We'll get you your mic and go on.
Te alistamos todo con el audio y todo listo.
And he says, brother Seth.
Dijo, hermano Seth.
Come over here and talk real quick.
Ven y habla conmigo un poco.
And he says, more or less words.
Y dijo estas palabras.
I see there's something that's pricking my heart right now.
Hay algo que está impactando mi corazón en este momento.
And I see you struggling in your mind.
Estás batallando en tu mente.
And I heard, the Lord told me that he heard your prayer.
Y el Señor me dijo que escuchó tu oración.
And right when you think the Lord is not listening to you.
Cuando usted piensa que el Señor no te está escuchando.
This is something that's real.
Es algo que es real.
I'm not making this up.
No es fábula.
Many people say he puts that on for a show.
Mucha gente dice, pues le dice eso nomás para decirlo.
Maybe there's some critics there saying it's telepathy.
Que quizá los críticos dicen que es nomás algo de la mente.
But a great friend came unto me.
Un gran amigo vino a mí.
And he says, you know the Lord.
Dice, ¿sabes el Señor?
Said he would have your victory.
Te dijo que ibas a tener tu victoria.
He's giving you the strength to overcome.
Te está dando la fuerza para
the
vencer.
Complexes that in your mind.
Los complejos que están en tu mente.
And he told me that you don't have to worry about that anymore.
Y me dijo que te dijera que no tienes que preocuparte por eso más.
I didn't tell nobody.
Yo no le dije a nadie.
I didn't tell anybody what was going on. I didn't even tell my own wife.
Y ni le dije a mi esposa lo que estaba aconteciendo.
But all I know is God heard my prayer.
Pero todo lo que sé es que Dios escuchó mi oración.
Church, you're not alone.
Iglesia, no están solos en esta noche.
Because the Lord Jesus loves you.
El Señor Jesús te ama.
He will give you strength.
Te va a dar fuerza.
And brother Diego helped me raise my faith.
Y hermano Diego ayudó a levantar mi fe.
And not only brother Diego.
No nomás el hermano Diego.
But every time I come to the house of the Lord.
Cada vez que vengo a la casa del Señor.
The Holy Ghost through his ministry.
Espíritu Santo a través del ministerio.
Our pastor.
Por el pastor.
The various ministers that are here.
Los ministros que están aquí.
They're here to pick you up.
Están aquí para levantarlos.
They want to take you to Jesus.
Te quieren llevar a Jesús.
They've been instructed by the Lord.
Están instruidos por el Señor.
You need to get them to my feet.
Necesita llevarlos a mis pies.
And we need help many times.
Necesitamos ayuda muchas veces.
And he helped me raise my faith.
Y él me ayudó a levantar.
And I was at the crowd.
Y estaba allí con la gente.
I was at the crowd there waiting.
Estaba con la gente ahí esperando.
And they said, we got to go up on that roof.
Digo, tenemos que levantarse
por ese techo. Somebody got to go up on that roof.
Alguien se tiene que subir en el techo.
Because if you need help to tear your roof down.
Necesitan ayuda para romper ese techo.
You may have a roof of complexes.
Quisiera tener un techo de complejos.
Of doubt.
De duda.
Of sin.
De pecado.
Maybe you're insecure about yourself.
Quizá no estás seguro de algo en este mismo.
Maybe you feel like you're the black sheep of the family.
Sé que es alguien que está fuera.
But once the ministry helps you break that down.
Cuando el ministerio te ayuda a romper eso.
They present you in front of Jesus.
Los presenta frente de Jesús.
And all he has to say to you.
Todo lo que le tiene que decir.
Is son.
Es hijo.
Daughter.
Hija.
Thy sins be forgiven you.
Tus pecados han
pagado. Arise.
Levántese.
I'll rise tonight.
Levántese en esta noche.
Come on, young people.
Vamos, jóvenes.
I know you're struggling
yo
right now.
Que están batallando ahorita.
And I'm putting my shoulder to the wheel with you.
Yo me estoy
because I believe in you.
Me estoy parando con usted.
Because if you can do it for me,
porque si lo puede hacer
you
para
can
mí,
do it for you.
Lo puede hacer por usted.
Don't give up hope.
No se rinda.
Because the Lord is on our side
el
right
Señor
now.
Está a nuestro lado.
And he wants to tell you.
Y le quiere decir,
arise.
Levántese. Yeah.
Take up your bed.
Tome su cama.
And go in thy house.
Y vaya a la casa.
Praise the Lord. Can you give the Lord a hand clap of praise?
Aplauso, Señor.
And if you can walk,
si puede andar,
if you can stand on your feet
si
tonight,
puede parar a sus pies,
if you can stand to your feet tonight,
si pueden parar, por favor.
And if you fell heir to his house,
si llega a ser herederos a su
if you believe
casa,
you're in his house,
si cree que está
you believe
en casa,
the promise is to you,
cree que la promesa es para
you believe it to your children,
y que es para sus hijos.
To those that are far off.
Aquellos que están lejos.
Why? Brother Branham says if he fell heir to his house.
El hermano Branham dice que si viene a ser heredero de su casa.
He said, I would like to move in.
Yo me gustaría moverme, entrar ahí.
I would like to look everything over.
Y me gusta mirar todo.
I want to see what's mine.
Quiero ver lo que es mío.
I want to see what I own.
Quiero ver que me pertenece a mí.
And when I fell.
Y cuando
heir to the kingdom of God.
Cuando vine a ser heredero del reino de Dios.
His eternal blessings.
Bendiciones eternos.
I like to walk around and see what's mine.
Yo quiero andar y a ver qué es lo que es mío.
I want to see what's on the shelves, brother Aaron.
Quiero ver qué está en esos estantes, hermano Aaron.
And don't you stand still for somebody to push you off in a corner.
No, y no sé nomás te para ahí alguien que lo empuje en la esquina.
Because every promise.
Porque cada promesa.
In this book is mine.
En este libro es
mío. It is yours tonight.
Es de usted en esta noche.
Would you bow your heads?
Puede inclinar su rostro.
If you feel like tonight you're this paralyzed man,
si usted se siente como este hombre paralizado, el paralítico,
and you feel like you've gone and messed up,
y usted va y quizá la ha regado,
Jesus is in the house tonight.
Jesús está en casa en esta noche.
There's your ministry who have given you the word.
Aquí está el ministerio que le ha dado
la palabra. Our brother Sam, our brother Aaron.
Mano Sam, hermano Aaron.
And there's many people in here with great faith.
Y hay mucha gente aquí con gran fe.
If you need help, just raise your hand to the Lord.
Levante su mano al Señor.
And in the name of Jesus,
en el nombre de Jesucristo,
you see your children, Lord.
Tú ves a tus hijos, Señor.
That are here.
Están aquí.
They want more of you.
Quieren más de ti.
And I say unto their condition.
Y les digo a la condición de ellos.
That their sons be their sins be forgiven.
Que sus pecados son perdonados.
I tell you.
Les digo.
To arise,
que se levanten.
Take up your bed,
tome su cama,
and walk.
Y anden.
Walk in the name of the Lord.
Anden en el nombre de Jesús.
Walk
Señor.
Upon faith.
Anden en la fe.
For the promises are to you.
Por las promesas son para usted.
Your children.
Sus hijos.
And to many as our God will call.
Y a todos los que Dios llamará.
Blessed in Jesus' name we pray.
En el nombre de Jesucristo oramos.
Amen.
Amen.
And all that is within me bless his holy name. Oh, bless the Lord, oh, with all my soul. Bless the Lord, oh. with all my soul. Oh, and all, oh, that is within me. Bless His holy, holy name. Oh, for He has done great things. Situations that tug of war at me, all day long I struggle, oh, for the answers that I need. Questions become clear. Oh, and for that sacred moment, yes, no doubts can interfere. For it's in the prayer. Oh, yes, drum. And if there ever were dreams that were lofty and noble, those were my dreams at the start. And the hope for life's best were the hopes that I harbored down deep in my heart. But my dreams turned to ashes, my castles all crumbled, my fortune turned.
To the Lord. Amen. He deserves all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. Él vino a mi corazón.
Oh, cuán glorioso es el cambio operado en mi ser. Oh, viniendo a mi vida el Señor.
Él vino a mi corazón.
glory in the highest. I will shout and sing, for yes, I'm standing on the promises. Pasada voy, tesoros mil dejé por seguir a Jesús. Los ángeles a mí me esperan a llegar y yo no siento que sea este mundo mi hogar.
¿Por qué queremos ir a la casa?
What are we going to do at home?
¿Qué vamos a hacer en la casa?
Sit there.
¿Estás sentado ahí?
I know at my house it's just me and my wife.
Yo sé que en mi casa solamente soy yo y mi esposa.
Boy, is it boring.
Oh, está bien aburrido.
Not that I'm... I love my wife.
Yo amo a mi esposa.
You know what I mean? It's just... There's nothing to do at home.
No hay nada que hacer en la casa.
Wife, I love you.
Yo, esposa, yo te amo.
But... There's nothing to do at home.
No hay nada que hacer en la casa.
You stay here all night.
Yo pudiera estar aquí toda la noche.
Glory. Thank you, yeah. Brother Sammy, Brother Aaron,
Hermana Aaron,
Brother Seth. Wow.
¿Cómo usted?
Thank you for that. Thank you for letting the Lord use you.
Gracias por permitir a que el Señor los usara.
Wasn't it awesome seeing Brother Abraham here?
No era tremendo ver al Máster Hermano Abraham aquí domingo.
Thank you so much.
Ah,
I don't think there's anybody in here that can worship like that.
No, que nadie aquí que puede adorar al Señor como él.
Wow. Good to see you, Abe.
Es muy bueno verte, hermano Abe.
Well, we don't have any announcements other than our service on Sunday.
No tenemos otro anuncio más que el servicio de domingo.
And those that will be traveling.
Los que van a estar viajando.
Let's remember everybody in prayer.
Vamos a acordarlos a todos en oración.
Amen.
Amen.
Your head.
Lord Jesus, we just thank you for this grand opportunity, Lord, to just be in your presence, Lord. There's not words in our human vocabulary to express our gratitude, Lord.
No hay palabras, Señor, el agradecimiento que tenemos.
But we just give our whole selves to you, Lord Jesus.
Nos damos nuestros todo a ustedes, Señor.
Now bless us as we all go to our homes, Lord.
Bendícenos a que vamos a nuestras casas.
May your angels encamp around about us, Lord.
Tus ángeles están con nosotros, Señor.
And keep us in the way.
Y aguárdanos en el camino.
Till we meet again.
Hasta que regresamos otra vez.
In the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
En el precioso nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Everybody ought to know. Everybody ought to know.